Good morning, everyone. My name is Laura Stranks, and I'm an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator here in Brisbane, Queensland, Australia. Thanks for joining me today. We're going to do shortly this half hexagonal pop-up card. I've done a couple of samples, and I'm going to do a different colour and design today as well. Just a couple of things before I start. I've introduced myself, and my name is Laura. My Facebook page is called Cards by Laura. In there, you can follow that group and or that page, and you will see all my cards that I do at my videos and my classes and workshops. There's no tutorials in there, just cards to look at and get designs. You're welcome to private message me if you want to know anything from there. I have a large Facebook group called Laura's Craft Room Tips and Tutorials. You can request to join that group. If you do request, there's a couple of questions you need to answer. One is why you wish to join the group, and also that you agree to the rules of the group. If you don't see the questions on the device that you're on, like say your phone, go to a different device, say your iPad or a PC. Just make sure you do answer the two questions, otherwise I do reject the invitation to join. And my YouTube channel, if you're watching for the first time today, it's called Creative Gems. Love you to subscribe if you haven't already done so. And if you've watched my videos before, love to have you comment and give me a like. And thanks for watching. So we'll put that aside and we shall get started. As usual, I have prepped a lot of my pieces and I have typed up the measurements for you. These measurements will be in the description box of the video. I do record my videos, so and I upload them after to YouTube. So, but you're welcome to comment in there, but you will get the measurements from the description box in there. And also then the PDF goes into the files tab in that large group, Laura's Craft Room Tips and Tutorials. So you can get the full tutorial out of there with all the instructions of how to assemble. There also is a featured tab in that Laura's Craft Room Tips and Tutorials. That is where I store my live videos from a Saturday morning. Every Saturday morning I do a live video in the group. We craft along together, and the PDF for that is in the files tab, and the video is pinned into the featured tab. So if you are joining, or if you have been there before, if you remember, that is where my things are stored. Now we shall get on to this with the pieces and all. I've already done all the prepping I need to do. I've got a couple of little extra things here that I need to show you. I think I've got everything ready. My first piece here, there's two parts to the base. It's shaded spruce. I have to double check that. It measures 6.5 by 5 inches. The height of the finished card will be 7 by 5. So the 5 is the height this way. The other piece in here is 4.5 by 5, and that will go on there at the back eventually. And then the two strips, which are the top and bottom pieces here to make it sit hexagonal, they measure 10¾ by 1 inch, and you'll need two of those. They're the same colour as the base. My basic white piece, which is going on the back, it measures 4 7/8 by 4 3/8. That's that one. My back strips are these. There's two of these. I'll just make sure I get the right ones. We'll know when we get to them. They measure 4 7/8. No, down here, the back strips. 4 7/8 by 3/4. There's two of those. I'll show you when we get to it. I haven't stamped anything on the back of this. And you can, I'll show you these two while we're here. This one I've stamped gold embossed on the back, and I've put the strips on. This one here I didn't put any strips, so I've stamped there and I've just put that. But if you want the full back without any anything on it. If you want the whole space for writing, you don't have to put anything on there. This one, I'm just going to put the two strips on the back and leave the rest as a writing space. So they'll go on the back there. That's those two strips there. And the DSP here, 4¾ by 3/4 are the two that are down in under here. They measure 4¾ by 3/4. That's design one. That's design one. It's going this way on that side of it. I'll mention the paper for this in a minute. Very pretty paper. And also the other piece in the center, which is that piece in there. It measures 4¾ by 4¼. And there's one of those. They're all in the same design. They're going inside underneath the strips. Then design two is the little six of pieces, which are top and bottom on those strips. I've changed the pattern on those. They're 2 inches by 3/4 of an inch. And I've got six of those. So I'm reversing the pattern there. That same pattern is on the back as well. And then a piece of window sheet, which I have not cut yet. I'll just get a piece out for you. I knew I'd forget that little thing. We've got plenty of window sheet here. It measures 4½ by 1 inch. I'll just cut that now so we've got it ready. Put that little piece away. I think this is already four, not quite. We'll go this way. You probably can't see this on the screen because it's clear. 4½ by 1 inch. I think it was 1 inch. Yes, 4½ by 1 inch. Which is that piece. We'll keep that aside. We don't need any more of that. So that's my piece of window sheet, and I'll show you where that goes. It's in the back of there, in underneath this this center arrangement here. It's down in underneath, so you can hold it up and it's just floating. So that's that piece there. Then I've got a heap of decorations here. I'll show you how I'm putting those together, and I've got some embellishments there as well. The two stamp sets that I've used, which we'll get to in a minute, I'm just putting hello on this one, which is this little one here. I've used the Stylish Shapes circles, and I've also used the images out of this, these two, and this little bit here where it's all little spot stamps. That's all the pieces. That, as I mentioned before, is in the description box of the video today. So we'll put that aside and we shall get to do some scoring. So you'll need your trimmer if you're a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator or you purchase Stampin' Up! Products. You will need your trimmer if you have one. And we'll score this piece first. So with the 6½ inch side at the top, which is that way, you're going to score at 1 inch on that side and rotate at 180 degrees and score at 1 inch on that side. When it's scoring where the measurements on both sides are the same on each end, I always score one side, rotate 180 and score the other side. That way you get an exact measurement and it's not going to be out in any way. We'll leave this out because we're going to do those strips as well. We'll put that bit aside. That bit doesn't need any scoring. And this piece here, these are scored at both the same 7/8 of an inch, which is just the two strokes before the one. 2 inches, you'll have both these the same, 4¼, which is over there, 6½, which is here, 8¾, this one you're just going straight across with your scoring, and 9 7/8, which is two strokes before the 10, if you're on a trimmer. In my group, a lady posted a conversion chart the other day. She's done two, actually. One's quite large. It's more measurements on it. And the other one's just 230 centimetres. I am pinning those into the featured tab in the group. So if you want to convert any of these measurements, you can do it through the, just check out the file in the files tab, that the post that she has put up. So then you can convert yourself. 7/8 of an inch again. And 2 inches. I basically work in inches the bulk of the time. That's just how I do it. I know it's, we should be doing the other way, but I prefer this way, but you can always convert it yourself. 4 1/4. I've done that one. 6 1/2. I know a lot of people prefer centimeters, but it's a personal preference. 8 3/4. There's that one there. And 9 7/8. There's lots of charts. If you Google conversion charts, you can always print one off yourself. This lady that has posted one, it's quite handy. So you can print that off for yourself as well. So you're just bending those all into mountain folds. We'll burnish those in a minute. Both of those go the same, all into mountain folds, like so. And we can put the DSP on them. Just get my bone folder wherever I've put it. There it is. So we'll just burnish all of these nice and crisp. I hope this video is nice and clear for everyone. I did record one the other day and it was quite blurry, but I worked out what was wrong. It was one of the settings on my phone that was in the wrong spot, so I had to redo a video, but it didn't take too long. I have been a demonstrator for, can't think if it's 7 or 8 years. I think it's 8 years. I'm at Silver Elite level. Love everything I do. My big group takes me up a fair bit of my time, and my videos, all my videos that I do, but I love doing what I do. I do host workshops and classes from my home here, and I have a nice little following. I've got a private group that are just my team members. I've got 10 ladies in my team. A couple of those have got ladies under them, which keeps me at Silver Elite level, so I'm happy with that. Now, these pieces here, we'll leave the back for a minute because the back section needs to go on after these strips. So what we're doing, we can put this one in. I don't think it's any sort of direction for that. I'm putting this pattern up on this one. I'll just get my liquid glue. I'm probably going to use liquid glue most of the way through this because it gives me a little bit of wiggle room to get things nice and straight. It's not difficult to assemble. I'll mention this paper too. It's called, I didn't get the pack out, but I will get it out and show you. It's very pretty. It's in the new mini catalogue. Actually, I think I might put it that way. It's in the mini catalogue. Regal something it's called. I'll get it out. I've used quite a bit of it already. This is my second pack because I'm doing a retreat in October. It's called Regal Winter. Very pretty papers. I won't open that one just yet. If you have a look in the catalogue, you can see what it looks like. I'm sure everyone's looked at it by now. When I first looked at it, I thought it was a bit dark and a bit busy, but once I bought it, it's absolutely stunning. Well worth getting. Yes, I'm hosting a retreat here in October, just a few weeks away. I have 13 ladies coming, with 3 ladies that can't come but would still like the projects. And they're doing 10 projects each, and everything is stamped and cut. All they have to do is assemble, And yeah, it's going to be a busy weekend. We do 2 days, the retreat. Most of the ladies live local or a little bit further away, not far. And yes, it goes over 2 days, two full days. We have prizes and we have one little game each a day. I supply morning tea. They bring their own lunch. And a really fun weekend. So I'm looking forward to that. That's all we need to do there for the minute. And we can get these little strips on this first. Now, all you do is put them on the three center panels, these three longer ones here. The two outside ones are going to be, and they're going this way. I better make sure I turn them up the other way so I don't put them on incorrectly. You can put this with the same pattern all the way across. You don't have to reverse your pattern. Some of the reverse ones on these don't really coordinate with the other side. They're a totally different pattern. This one, I know it's sort of toned in with this pattern. So we'll do both of these. I thought I could have stuck some of these down beforehand, but it doesn't take too long. Bear with me while I do a bit of gluing. Beautiful day here today. So looking forward to our retreat. A friend of mine helps me with the retreat. I wouldn't know what I'd do without her. We have had one full day of prepping. We went from 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. one day, prepping, doing all the fiddly bits, the cutting and the stamping bits and all that. And then I've got another lady coming to help on another day. We need the other one now. Where did I put the other one? Over here. Nearly stuck it to the wrong place. There's another lady coming in a couple of weeks to help, or in a week or so, to help with the final bits, the mats, just the mats and the base parts and stuff. We've done all the hard part. And then they've got to go into bags, which I have bought some just from the reject shop. Cheap white bags, craft bags, and I've decorated those. I've got table gifts done. We have quite a few table gifts, and we have a large, well, it's not a raffle, it's just a door prize, but we bundle up a big basket of stuff for some lucky winner that is going to win it, and it's a fun weekend. So that's all of those. Now we're going to put them onto this piece, and there's a special way of doing this, which I should know it by now, because it's so you're going to flip all of these over to the back side. Now this first score line here on this one is going to line up with the first score line on this one. Now let me get it right. Every time I do this, I end up with it wrong. That way. No. Over. That way. Oh, that's why I do it wrong. It's got to sit in there. And then this score line is lining up with that score line there. The first score line on this piece and the first score line on that. Sit that on top of there. I think that's... Hang on and we'll get it right again. Yes, that way. It's like that. That's it. So put the edge there, but this first score line, bring it across like that. I knew I'd get it eventually. And that score line is going to line up with your first score, this only score line here. So flip it across completely, both sides like that, and then line that up with that other score line. Now you should have a little tiny piece overhang here down on that that edge. This will be level with the bottom, but this here will have a slight overhang. That allows it to pivot backwards and forwards. So make sure that is lined up like that and hold it there like that. Open that back up and then get your glue and fill up both of those sections with glue. It's a little bit tricky to start. Just ignore that first bit where I fumbled around a bit. But just make sure that's still in its place. That's lined up with that. Give it a little push down. So make sure it's level with the bottom here. And it's got about of a 16th of an inch overhang there on the sides. And then the same with this side. Line up. Once you do one side, this side should line up by itself. So you're putting that on there. You've got the little overhang here on that edge. Open it back up and put the glue on there. So you're not lining up with that section, that score line there. That's where the overhang is going to be. If you do it the other way, it doesn't sit as well. So then bring that back across, lined up with that score line, the two score lines. Make sure it's level at the bottom, level with the bottom of the card. And that is that piece. And then we're going to do the same with the top. We shall put this in, bring that across first, line it up with the top edge and the score line. So that score line is lined, first score line on your strip and the score line on the base piece should line up. And just keep them nice and even while you've glued, put your glue on. And glue all over both of those tabs. Bring that back across. Make sure we'll flip it around so we can see it a little bit better because I couldn't see the above bit there. Make sure that's level with the bottom of the card base. And the same on this side. Just double check that that's lining up. The two score lines are lining up and level with the bottom. Open it back up. And put some glue on there. Close it back across. This is why we don't do the back until we've done these strips. Because it's got to go over the top of this other panel that we had originally, that will go on there that way. And before I put it on there, I'm going to put my white piece on here. I can stamp this later if I needed to stamp anything. There's about a 16th border around the edge of the white. I might just do a little die cut and put on this later on. You won't see me do it, I'll do it after, but it will be in the PDF, the photo of what it looks like. I didn't think to stamp anything on this. I don't always need a lot of space to write a little message. So that's that. I should have put these on first, but I didn't. I usually put them on first before I adhere the base bit. But I think they cut the correct length to fit in there. They go from the white edge to the white edge. See, we didn't do it right. Have I done those? Yes, I've done those. I've cut these too long. Oh, I know. We shall wipe that glue off. I know why, because it's got to go this way. I would have known that if I had a stamp in there. So all good, we can put them this way. Lucky we noticed that before it got too sticky. That's my husband sneezing in the background. He sneezes a lot and coughs a lot. There he goes again. I told him if the phone rings to please answer it straight away, because nothing more annoying than the phone ringing in the background. I didn't tell him don't sneeze. It's a bit hard not to, I suppose. I think he did try to muffle that second one. So there we go, that's better. And then this whole piece will go on the back section here. So we can glue that on. And we just have to do our centerpiece on the front. The other card that I did one more of these. It was for my daughter, a friend of hers. It was her 50th. And my daughter had another group of ladies. This one, this piece goes from score line to score line on here. There's no extra, it's just a cover for the to cover those strips. Yes, she had I think it was five other ladies that were signing the card, so there was plenty of room on the back for her. And I did it as a 50th. It had a big 50. I'll post the card in my group once I've finished the video. And yes, they loved it. They thought it was gorgeous. Now these pieces here, and I didn't realize they're all out of this Regal Flora. This set goes with the paper, and it's got this one here that cuts out a little frame as well as the insert. And then I've stamped this little piece here, this little flower, and some of the dots on the greeting. So I've used pretty much all of that. The dies cut out the flowers and the leaves. And what I'm doing, I had to manipulate a little bit because I wanted a white center and I wanted the green frame. I decided, and I'll get my, wherever it was, my silicone mat, which I put somewhere, and now it's not there. So we'll just work on the, I don't know where I put it. I had it a minute ago, or I had it earlier this morning, and now it's not there. That's okay, we'll work on this. I'll clean it up later. I want this frame around here, but because it's got nothing to attach it back to, this is cut in two pieces. So I cut a green panel, which I have put away somewhere. This is the white panel that came off that one. I'm not going to use that. I don't know where I put the green one. And I want to put that green around that. So what I'm doing, I flip this over and I've cut a couple of little 3/8 inch strips that I'm going to put across the two joins there to join them back together, because I don't want it coming apart. And I'm going to use my seal, this one, and I shall put a little bit on here like so, and then I'm going to join those two back together just like that. You won't see the back of this, like that, and another one on the bottom edge. Just to hold them together, because where they're going to sit on the frame, on the band, is not going to hold it stable to hold it without falling apart. Now, our window sheet, you'll need that first, and we want some glue dots and a pick tool. And I'm just going to put three glue dots on top and bottom of the window sheet, and we can attach it to the on the underside of those two strips. I wouldn't recommend liquid glue on this because it'll blurry around and make a big mess. You could put a strip of tear and tape, would work. Tear and tape's good, just not liquid glue. And then you're just going to slide this in under here, like so, and hold it central. You can feel it underneath that it's not going to hang out the ends, top and bottom. And just adhere that in there. Easy to do, and it's right center in the middle. Then I'm going to put this. Now, this here has got some little slots there that I was going to slot these little pieces into. But because I've covered it over, I'm just going to put them on the outside of it. But there are slots in both of the rounded corners. So if you use this die, you can just slot them into there. Actually, I could slot them into the green, though I won't. I'm going to put them on the outside. So I've got a green, I've stamped a green image, and this little cherry cobbler, that is. And I'm just going to put them on the edge of there. So I might use my seal again, so it doesn't put glue everywhere. Just pop those two up in there, like so. And the other one down on the bottom corner, I might just put the two together so they don't come apart first. And then some glue on the bottom edge of this. And pop that down that way. So long as it doesn't pop up over the outside, these outside edges of your card, you'll be fine. Then I've got this little, this is with the stylish shaped circles. I've made that. I'm going to pop that up on dimensionals. Get a new pack out. I used all the others today. This will go in the center. I've got some embellishments there as well that go with this suite. I usually buy, there's a nice ribbon that goes with this suite as well. Very pretty ribbon. It's in the cherry cobbler. I think it's cherry cobbler and gold. So that in the center of there. Now I'm going to put this up on dimensionals as well. So I'm going to put some, I'll just judge. I need to put something else over that. I had that little bit of cardstock before. This piece here, we might put this, just pick that up over there. I might just put that over the top of that to hold all that together. That just turned out to be the right size for the back of that, just so it doesn't all come apart, because I don't have to line it up. We can use the seal on that. So if you cut a piece pretty much same size as that and stick that down, that gives you a base to work with. It's not all going to come apart. Now I can put that there, and I'm going to put some, I'll flip it over like this and place it where I want it. I'll just get a pencil, and so long as I keep my dimensionals inside that area there, up and down, then it, they're not going to show. Where did I put them? Over here. So I'll just put, I'll put two, we'll just scatter them up the middle, will be good. Just another way of decorating. So we can pop that in there, center it in the middle, that will go flat, fairly straight, and that is my card. We could put embellishments across there too, which is what I did with this one here. This one here I didn't put anything, but I have got some embellishments, and I'm just going to put them on the, that this one took a lot of die cutting with all the flowers all over it, so we don't need all that. We'll put some embellishments on this. There's a couple of different colours. All these colours line up with the colours in the papers. I might use, I'll stick with the dark one. We'll put them on the greeting. I'll just scatter them on the greeting. And a couple out the side. Trying to put them in a scattering, like so. There we go. Put all those back away later. And that's my card for today. I hope you enjoyed that. I love that paper. So, so pretty. That's the back. I don't think I will stamp anything on the back. I'll just leave it plain. But that's using that whole suite with the paper. There is a ribbon. I could put a little bow on those if I wish, but I think that's quite enough on there. And this one here, this was the original one I made, the happy birthday one. And that was my first Christmas card I've made. So lots to choose from. Thank you for joining me today, and I shall catch you all again next Monday at 9 a.m. And I hope you have a lovely week. Bye for now.